Clarification about the question from a forum, Adalo forum, and about how to create the functionality of question of the day. Of course, there are different approaches to that. You can do it in various ways. I decided to find a simple way. Of course, it's gonna have some limitation, as all simple ways do. So the limitation is gonna be, first of all, we have a same question for per day for all users. Then second, question is changed every day. Okay, maybe it's these are two, not limitations, this is functionality. So they're not going to be fully random. So they are going to be displayed in cycle, but they need to be seen to be random to users. So with this functionality, it's pretty easy to create the question of the day function. So what I did, I have already created daily questions collections. These are the questions. Two important things, we have question and we have question number here. Question number should be sequential from zero to the number of questions you have, minus one. And there should not be any holes in it, like should be one, two, three, four, five, fully sequential. It's not a good idea to use ID here, because if you, for example, delete this question, the next one will be ID 8, not 4. So it's better to keep a question number as a separate property. So the thing is that what we're going to do in this collection, I'm going to take the question based on the current day. You may know that in Adalo, current day could be is stored in numeric format, and we can even get this day number from date and time, current time property. So we can display it like this. So we use custom formula and we use date and time, current time, and this will be non-integer number, and the absolute will be I will show another formula again, custom formula, it will we'll use int function, int of date and time, current time. So if I run the preview, you'll see this is the full number, and this is the day ID. So actually we just need to take the day ID and based on it decide which question we are going to display and show this question to all users. So first let's add the custom list here. It's going to be a list of daily questions, and here we have current daily question, question number, and the question itself. So but now we need to add the filter, and we can see that it's not possible to add the custom formula in the filter. Well, there are a few workarounds. One option is to add something to a logged-in user collection, some property, and filter by this property and set this property somewhere before going on the screen or on screen enter. Another option, which I will I'm going to use now, is to filter through the text input. So I'm going to put the input, let's call it question ID input, and here I'm going to filter it that question number should be equal to question ID input, this one, and here I'm going to put the custom formula where we calculate the current question ID. So this is, I'm going to use a modular function so that the remainder of the division of the day number minus the absolute value of the day number without any decimals will be the ID of the question. So I have explained the logic already in my reply in the forum. So please consult this post if you don't understand how it works. So here I'm going to just quickly create a formula. So we are taking the day number. So of course we're not taking the day number with decimals. So we need to take the absolute value of the number. Then minus, we are taking a big integer out of, again, this should be an integer, I don't need a parenthesis here, an integer of day number, we are getting current day number, divided by the number of questions, which is 7. Better hard-coded counts may not always work correctly, but I mean, that depends. And then I multiply it by number of questions. So this, with this, we will get the remainder of the division. And well, I mean, this is pretty much it. I'm running the test here and question of the day. So you see the remainder of the division of today is question number 4. So, and if we take, for example, well, it's difficult to test it here. Let me add the question to show that it works differently. So let it be question 7 with a question number 7. So you see, now we have 8 questions in total. And okay, well, it's the same remainder. Ah, of course, I forgot to put the correct number here. Okay, you see the remainder is different. So again, the full explanation is here. I hope that this was useful. Thank you.